What if you can't lift heavy weights? What if, even though you buy into the idea heavy weights is best for bone density, in other words, you believe science and you also know it's best for boosting your metabolism, but what if you're one of the women who have arthritis, or you have fibromyalgia, or an existing or pre-existing injury that keeps you from lifting heavy? What's a girl to do? Well, I'm going to give you 7 secrets. And actually, spoiler alert, I may have given you a bonus. 7 secrets to more muscle in menopause if you can't go heavy. I'm Deborah Atkinson. You're listening to Flipping 50, where I address your top struggles and concerns, and I share what to eat, how to move, and how to change your mindset so that you can have the energy and the vitality that you want, need, and deserve in this second and better half. And if you're listening to this and this topic is really interesting to you, one that you're really sure you need to know a little bit more about but aren't quite sure where to go, you're going to want to tune in if you're joining on time. August 11th, I'm doing a masterclass talking about how the exercise you're doing may actually be causing accelerated muscle loss. And none of us wants that. So what's the answer to preventing it? I'm sharing all of it with a little checklist. In fact, you'll walk away with that cheat sheet. And later this month, I'm opening up something called our 10-day Hot Not Bothered Challenge. I've offered it once this year, and it was a huge hit. This will be the last time you see it in 2021. So pay attention, and I'll see you on the inside. Maintaining muscle in menopause, let alone gaining it, and the desired muscle tone that comes with that, can get tricky if you are unable to lift heavy weights. These 7 not-so-secret secrets will remind you that you do have options, even if heavy isn't one of them. However, this isn't about, not just about, svelte arms or those void of bowings. It's independence coming down the pike in a decade or two. It's balance and agility and reaction skills. So walking that uneven golf course is not a big deal. If you've got a history of injury, prior injury limiting your ability to lift, or a condition that deems heavyweight more risk than reward, this is for you. That said, even if you are able to lift heavy, sometimes for those of us more naturally muscular or at a plateau or just plain tired of the same kind of workouts, adding one or more of these to your next workout can make things so much more inspired again. Cheers to more muscle in menopause. Tell me in the comments which one you're going to use first. And for our Flipping 50 members, I'd really love to hear from you, as I'm about to record a new series just for you featuring the strategies here. All right, number 1, time under tension. For muscle in menopause, when you can't go heavy, this is a favorite of mine. Tempo training, I call it, allows you to use a lighter weight if needed and still be able to reach muscular fatigue. Now, to be clear, the stress still may not be optimal for bone density benefit. However, if you are limited by an injury or condition, say arthritis, that has competing needs with bone density, the condition that stands to suffer the most wins. In other words, dominates what exercise prescription we use. Adding more time under tension is something most gym goers need to do. If you've ever been to the gym, even the hotel gym, you'll see a lot of very interesting and undesirable strategy. But most typical is about a 1 to 2 second lift and a similar 1 to 2 second lower. Listen, the basics of basics for ideal strength training is a speed of about 1 to 2 seconds of a lift in a 3 to 4 seconds lower. And I can tell you that ad nauseum, I repeated that for 16 years because often I taught 4 different sections of a similar course. So over and over on a given day, I might be telling that to a class full of 30 to 60 students, not remembering. Have I said this already? All right. So those are the basics. That makes each repetition an average of about 6 seconds. I can tell you right now that most of us are not taking that long. We're speeding through it. And because of that, we're potentially missing some of the results. There are other techniques, and adding power is beneficial. That's a degree of strength in a lift. It's actually very beneficial for bone density and for weight loss. However, back to the need to choose lighter weight or simply test yourself or get off a plateau, tempo training offers a lot of variety. I will often suggest something like a 2-4-2-4 tempo. Here's how that works. So in addition to slowing the move down in both the lift and the lower, what I've done is added a hold on each end. So talking you through it, it goes like this. Imagine you're lying down on your back, maybe on a bench, maybe on the floor, to do a chest press. You've got your dumbbells in your hands. You're going to press up to extension in a 4 count. So give that a 4 seconds, 4 counts. You're going to hold at the top for 2 counts. You're going to lower down in 4 counts. And then you're going to hold for 2 counts. So imagine it. Do it with me. So you're going to raise up 1, 2, 3. Now you're at full extension. Hold for 2, 1. Now lower down. 1, 2, 3, 4. Hold it here. 2 counts. And we lift again. You get the idea. Now, that's a single repetition. It now takes 14 seconds as opposed to the typical, probably 4 seconds most of us would hurry through. You try it with weights this time, not the air dumbbells you just did. And tell me if you don't feel that weight you thought you'd outgrown just got a little heavier. Secret number 2 is reach temporary fatigue. Now, that's no secret, really. So I'm telling you that all the time. But slowing down is one way to do it, which is what we just described. But doing something called a drop set is another example of how to do that. And we can reach temporary fatigue not just once, but multiple times in the same set with a drop set. Increasing exercise volume is actually beneficial for women over 40. And it's emerging in the literature more and more. However, with obstacles you and I have like time and energy that could result not just in muscle fatigue, but overall fatigue without adequate rest, it's best to add volume not by doing more days per week, but by doing more sets or reps in a workout. Drop sets, and I also call them monster sets because some of my clients do think they're a little scary. They're often done in the gym, but there's no reason you can't do them at home if you have at least 3 or even 4 pairs of weights that you can choose from. Your first set of weights that you use, the very first set, needs to bring you to fatigue and ideally at about 15 repetitions. And by the way, if you don't have a weight that does that for you, you need to go shopping because you should be reaching fatigue by 15. I prefer to do, and I have clients do 4 sets of 15 repetitions when we do drop sets. You reach fatigue, you reduce the weight, meaning if I did a 15 repetition set with my 15 pounds, then I would stop. I would put those weights down. I would pick up my next set, whether that's I have 10s or 12s, and I would go immediately again. We don't rest fully. We start right back. So it's much more like number 16, number 17, right? So you resume the set and you actually, it's a continuation of the first set. And at the end of each 15 repetitions, you should be at fatigue again. And if not, you want to do a few more repetitions so you do get there. It's essential that you reach that fatigue each time before you switch and then lighten your load again and come back to the next set. It is the fatigue each of those four times that makes this effective. So if you've never tried that, try it. It's one of the popular workouts that we'll put into our stronger programs in the Flipping 50 membership. Secret number three, isolated single joint exercises after compound exercises. So what do I mean by that? Isolated single joint exercises can increase the stimulus to cause muscle growth in the specific muscle we target. However, it needs to follow compound exercises or you're just not getting enough bang for your menopause metabolism buck. You cannot stand or sit and do a set of bicep curls and expect to fire up your metabolism. That muscle group is, yes, falls under the category of major muscle groups, but it is relatively small compared to your glutes, your quadriceps, your chest, or your back. You need to work those major muscle groups first in compound exercises. That means there are a lot of joints involved, like squats, where we're flexing at our ankles, our knees, and our hips, or like a chest press, where we're moving through our shoulders and our elbows. So those kinds of exercises are far more valuable because as more joints are involved, more muscles crossing those joints have to be also involved. Compound exercises move multiple muscles, boost the energy expenditure during and after a workout. Bonus, this is the kind of work that increases metabolic effects of strength training. Rarely, if ever, does it deserve or does it serve you to do isolated muscle groups only as a woman in midlife wishing to live her healthiest second half? Secret number four is alternate intensity in the volume of your workouts. This is potentially one of the biggest secrets because so many women would say, go hard or go home. And some memes were meant to be ignored. And always go hard or go home is one such meme. Never ever does a professional athlete, an amateur athlete, nor should you always build. Your fitness level will actually decline and you'll be probably experiencing more breakdown leading to injury trying to do that. I use the same strategy with women in menopause that I would use with collegiate athletes or world champion triathletes. There's a rotating schedule of building and recovery weeks. If you exercise intentionally, it helps to think of yourself as an athlete, just wiser. And what I mean by that is you are in this for life, not to put yourself at risk for a single competition. I keep that approach with Flipping 50 programs. For me to give you a four-week shred program that if done, and definitely if continued, would damage your hormones immensely would be a disservice. Those programs are sexier, and trust me, they sell. But I'm not going to play that game. I'll be here when you need the repair afterward. Keep in mind, an athlete, a model or celebrity does not care about long-term health in the same way you do. Now, that's not to say Jennifer Aniston doesn't want to age well, but right now, what pays her bills and gets her movies is a certain weight, right? So you've got to think about what they're willing to do to reach what they're able to reach may also be causing long-term damage. And you can have both the short-term results and the long-term results. Secret number five, change the way you do exercises. using different angles and using unilateral versus bilateral. And what I just said is using one arm at a time versus two, or use a range of motion unique to the exercise. That's one way I manipulate different fiber stimulation. Not every chest press is the same, and you have a body that lives and moves 360 degrees. The more angles and variations used, the more fibers we recruit. And the more muscle fibers we recruit, the more beneficial the strength and metabolism boost. Now, this is not what you can't see here is the asterisk in this paragraph, but this is not variety for variety's sake. There's a line where function is enhanced and where time spent increases without much return on investment. So you don't want to be crazy moves that look good or this is a good move. What you have to always be asking is this a good move for the goals that I have and for the needs that I have? And the next secret is limit the amount of cardio you do. I should probably say that again. Definitely, you want to prioritize your strength. Move more, but don't do more cardio. And this is where most women get it wrong. Do a limited interval training. Because something is good does not mean more is better. Kick your endurance cardio to the curb if you want to see and feel positive effects of your strength training on your muscle tone and definition. So your week might actually look like two strength training sessions, two interval training sessions, and a lot of walking daily, short walks, medium walks, longer walks, if you have time and energy and want to. But the less steady state endurance cardio, too much like the 1980s that you do, the better. Move more, because we all do need to offset the time we spend sitting. But long endurance is not the answer for you right now. Next is this, and this is number 7. Get the rest and the sleep required for muscle in menopause. Without adequate sleep, the anabolic or the growth hormones that you need can't be produced in the amounts needed for muscle support. That production occurs in your deepest cycles of sleep. So while the queen of rest is sleep, this also means handle your stress. If you're doing the best workouts in the world and you're uber stressed or not eating or sleeping, you can't reap the rewards from the exercise. So consider what you need to ditch, which stressors you can ditch and where you can, and enhance your coping skills for stressors that will always be there. Never in your life has your skill in this area been so important. A lifetime of putting others and other things first, staring at you, making this one hard for many women. There's no way around it. Anything else you want and want to do depends on dealing with stress and the feedback that your body is giving you. All right. Now, I promised it was a spoiler alert. There is a bonus. So last but not least, you cannot grow muscle or boost your metabolism without adequate protein and carbohydrate. And it's just not happening. In the women I work with, they're far more likely to reach for a protein bar and ask me, what kind of bar would you use if you weren't cooking? And I, the answer I have is not very nice, because I don't use a bar unless I'm out alone on a bike and I need to be able to reach into my fanny pack and grab one. Or I'm on a run 10 miles from home and I need to reach into my fanny pack to get that. There's no other good reason, and especially if you're in your house and in your kitchen and you're reaching for a barcode, something wrapped in plastic, and you have access to fresh fruits and vegetables and high-quality sources of protein, something's wrong. Something is desperately wrong, and we need to fix it right now. So listen, adequate protein and carbohydrate, but coming from real, very recently alive, requiring sunshine and rain to grow types of things. The glycogen that has to be in your muscle for strength training to be beneficial comes from food. Make sure you're not short sheeting yourself. Eating more can result in losing more. If you're fasting or you're doing keto with nearly no carbs, you're probably coming up empty. There's no fuel waiting there to use. And then in the case of fasting, potentially there's not enough to go in afterwards since you're playing catch up instead of getting ahead. So if you're doing intermittent fasting, I recommend doing your strength workouts in your eating window. Make sure that you're on a rotation of intermittent fasting. So it's not every single day to the maximum that you're fasting. Some days you should probably bust that fast and not do it at all. Do intuitive eating. Eat when you're hungry, but eat regularly to maintain metabolic flexibility, because otherwise what you may indeed be doing is simply slowing your metabolism. Make sure that you're giving yourself 24 hours after strength training workouts to take in extra fuel, specifically protein, but also carbs that you need for a muscle. Yes, even if, and actually especially if, you're trying to lose weight, every action you do is either helping or hurting your metabolism. But listen, don't take my word for it. Go get a smart scale and watch the results of your daily and weekly habits for yourself. There you have it. 7 secrets for more muscle in menopause, plus a bonus. And if you're listening early enough on August 11th, is the masterclass I was speaking of, and you can still make it. I'll put the link in the show notes. If in case you don't make that, you still might want to check out the 10-day hot not bothered challenge if you're ready for a set or a reset. What are you waiting for? Let's start flipping 50 today.